me come out there.
Do it.
I'll turn you over my knee.
Do it.
And his opponent.
Talk.
Introducing first.
So I guess just...
He weighs in at 185 pounds. He is from Shreveport, Louisiana. Mr. By the Book, Gaston LaRue. And his opponent is from the highways and the byways. He is Mac Sterling.
Thank you.
All right, man, we're joining you kind of late. But
your
USA
winner, Mr. By the Book, Gaston LaRue.
Yeah, sorry, we got on here late, having technical difficulties. But yes, you're not confused. That is Max Sterling in the ring. Blake gave Mac a chance to be rehired.
Once again, your winner, Gaston LaRue.
He had to beat Gaston, and then we saw the blatant interference by Dutch Boy.
Which the referee was, let's go to the
Mac,
ring.
What happened? Come on, I fired you last week, and this week, out of the kindness of my heart, I said I want you to show me everything that you had, and maybe I would rehire you. So what do you guys think? Should I rehire Mac Sterling? Oh, come on, I know you could do better than that. Should I rehire Mac Sterling? Yeah! Well, honestly, I don't know. So, Mac, I want you to get out of my building. You didn't impress me tonight. But next week, I will give you one more opportunity to show me why you should be on my roster. But as far as tonight goes, you're leaving unpaid. Now get out of my damn building. Go through the front door. Don't you dare hit his music. I'll fire you too. Now, Nikki, come here and make yourself useful.
All right, well, yeah, Max Sterling still fired. Not getting paid.
Joke's on him. Well, I go under
no,
the second rope.
Not saying, he basically said he's going to give him another opportunity.
Next week. At Black Friday. Blake Friday.
But he's not getting
first
paid.
Right. I don't know. If I was Mac, I wouldn't show up.
I don't know how I feel about
your
that.
Your referee that's up to Mac, is though. Angel.
Look, his opponent was complaining about being hurt. The ref was checking on him.
Yeah.
And out of nowhere, here comes Dutch Boy. You know.
What match do we got next? Do you know? I don't. All right. Well, we got Marshall Silver.
Yeah.
You know, Pete, last week, I had a guest in here since you were absent.
Yeah, I know who you had in here.
Yes. Quicksilver, also the grandfather of Marshall Silver, did not have kind things to say about Marshall. I swear, he's like Logan Roy from Succession. Like, just he does not like his kids.
Well, you got to remember, man. Quicksilver comes from that old school trait, man. He's kind of like, you got it or you don't got it.
All right. Well, this is another version of Flash that we haven't seen. He's going through some kind of like identity crisis as of late. Different music, look, different gear, yeah.
I believe we were at a show not too long that someone told us that sometimes you have to rebuild to recreate yourself to make yourself better.
Yeah, they didn't know what they were talking about. Rebuild to make yourself better. That's just
recreate.
More work. If it's already built, why don't you just build on the foundation you already have? No one tears down a house to add on an addition.
I might, man. If I don't like my house.
Then why'd you buy it?
Because I liked it when I bought it.
Same thing about the first wife, right?
Yeah. Here we go, Mississippi.
You liked
Bad
it
one.
When you bought it.
This match got a little bit of everything so far right now.
Yeah, it does.
We got
Cowboys, Punks.
We got some speed.
And their opponents.
All right, who else we got coming out now?
I got some turkey in here. I got some mac and cheese. Celebrate Thanksgiving a little early here at the Dub.
Yeah.
Look at Hold on. Well, that's... That looks like Timmy. But no bear, which we saw Dalton Davis decapitate at Halloween. Freaky Friday.
Yes.
Different music?
He has not been
attitude.
The same.
No.
He has not been the same since that match. It's like he's gotten,
Yeah.
Deep inside
his
soul.
Partner.
Is this like midlife crisis, millennial depression, Timmy, that most of us his age are suffering through?
It's scary looking, Timmy, if you ask me.
Well, Timmy's always been scary looking. All right, well, we recognize this music, so I gotta mute it.
Yeah, so coming to the ring next.
Not due to copyright issue, due to the fact that it's ICP.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But Pogo coming to the ring. That was kind of an interesting video.
Hold on. I gotta say this right now. One of the comments. Colby Jack just left a comment. The cow doesn't know how to speak, but he knows how to use a computer and use Facebook.
Look, somebody probably coded in some things and trained him how to just hit the one button.
Kind of like how they teach elephants to pay.
Yeah, so he just hits the one button with his hoof and it'll say move.
That's just weird. A cow using Facebook.
Hey.
You know,
that was an interesting video that came out this week, though, with Pogo and JB, man. Set up that match next week. That
introducing
triple threat
match,
yes,
man.
Yes.
Team
well,
number
I mean,
one.
That was last
team
week.
Team of
but, yeah.
Marshall
yeah.
Silver.
He gave him the opportunity last week.
And unbreakable Damon Jackson.
Now going to a triple
team
threat match.
Team number two is the Outlaw
Friday,
Johnny
next
Flash.
Friday.
And the Mississippi the Bad Boy, Zay Gates.
JB and the Savage Pogo.
Team number three, accompanied to the ring by Freak on a Leash, we have Timmy, also known as Reggie.
I'm not a betting man, but if I was, I might have to put
and
my
his
money
partner,
on Pogo on that match.
Savage Pogo.
I'm just saying.
It's like betting on the Jets to win.
They beat my Bengals, so I can't really say much.
Yeah, that's true. All right.
Yeah. Any given Friday,
like,
man.
That's like betting that Joe Burrow won't throw an interception on his second attempt. So, yeah, we got some tag team action here.
I'm not sure.
Oh, my God.
All right, looks like a three-way tag team matchup. And I'm going to mute us for a second and tell my cameraman where to move. All right, we got him. So, yeah, unfortunately, we're having some camera issues tonight. That's why we got on late. That's why this is the only camera angle we have tonight. So, yay, technology.
Wow, big clothesline right there by Marshall Silver.
That was. You know, his grandfather might groan a little less after that one. I don't think he'd say it was good, though.
No. Flash with a quick save.
I mean, it was a save.
Yeah. Oh.
Hey,
chop right there.
That.
Good chop.
Mono bought up and get it up over the top rope.
Yeah, I'm sure you guys heard that one. Yeah. Just trying to get the best shots here, though. All right, going for a pin. One, two, no, only a one count.
Get in, Timmy. Come on, he can beat this group, Tay. They're trying to fight girls and shit in here.
right. Yeah, so the guy in the ring going, locking up with Timmy. Newcomer to the dub named Damon Jackson. Great. Look. That's two Damons here.
That's, look.
Or three, honestly, because I can't tell two of them apart.
That just shows you, folks, we got people wanting to come
yeah.
to the dub on a regular basis. We're always having new people show up.
So, yeah, he's new to us, just like he's new to you guys. We're kind of interested to see how he fares here. In the ring with Pogo, ducks under the clothesline.
Oh,
and just tagged out. He wasn't doing it, having any of that with
Pogo. He was not that elbow that was getting ready to hit him. He's like, no.
That's a bony elbow, man. That thing hurts.
Yep.
That elbow's got a knife-like point to it.
All right, lock them. Whoa.
I think that was an enziguri, kind of. And Timmy stumbled in to break up the count. Flash tried to hit him.
Ref needs to be careful. She's not ready to get stepped on in there.
She's about to get ran over. Am I the only one that squishes like the roll before they eat it? Is that weird?
Everybody does.
Okay. That's what everybody was.
It's even better if it's got butter on it.
It's even better if it's got sausage gravy on it.
Well, wait a minute. Pogo with a quick victory
Your
there.
Your winners, the team of Pogo and Reggie.
That is not Reggie.
The other teams tried to come in to make the save, but Timmy Turner went over and cut him off.
Give it up for Pogo and Reggie.
Well, Pogo with the win going into next week.
That's not Reggie. I know that for sure. Actually, have you seen Reggie tonight? I have not.
Yeah, I saw him just for a short bit, and then he had to take off, and I'm not sure where he went to.
Okay. So he is here.
Yeah, he's here somewhere. I'd like to thank Reggie for taking care of Inside the Dub this week while I was a little bit under the weather, man. But I'm all good. I'm back. Just them deals, man. The older you get, the harder it is to get over some stuff.
Like hangovers?
Yes.
Yes.
All right, well,
give
look,
it up again for Pogo and
into,
Reggie.
He's got the momentum going into
Blake,
Blake
Friday,
Friday.
Man.
Yeah. And again, folks, Blake Friday next Friday. Tickets still just $12. Surprised that Blake hasn't raised the ticket prices yet.
Who's ready for your next matchup?
But, doors open at 6:30. Yeah. And Blake will probably fire somebody starting
first.
At 7:30.
And also, don't forget, we have a special show next Thursday.
Yes, Thanksgiving night. Yep. All the stores are closed.
Yeah, $5.
The game, look, it's going to be the Cowboys on TV. Probably, who are they playing? The Lions? The Washington
I think
team?
Lions and Bears are playing each other Thanksgiving morning.
Noon. Only one of those teams has like a winning record. They're really going to be worth watching.
Yeah,
no.
All the major stores are closed.
Oh. Brody Bodkins making his way to the ring. Now, we've seen him.
I wasn't here last week, but I did see the video where he ended up attacking Jackson Morgan.
I haven't seen anybody go at Jackson Morgan. Like, just want to go face-to-face. He saw Jackson and was like, that's the dude that I need to fight to establish my dominance here in WCWO, and that's exactly what he's doing.
From what I've seen, man, he doesn't.
And his opponent
intimidated.
Well, he was a little spooked when he sat up after getting attacked. I'll say that.
Yeah.
But then again, we all were. Like you saw, hell, I was back there talking to Jordan. I don't know why, but I had to talk to him about something. Yeah.
What?
Yeah,
you
we
was
were
talking
back,
to Jordan
I,
James.
I had to look. I got to do my job whether I like the person or not. All right.
Yeah.
But, yeah, we were all just like, hold on, did homeboy just sit up right after getting beat down like that? Like, yeah, he did. Hadari making his way to the ring to take on the behemoth Brody Bodkins, who informed me that I spelled his name wrong and I've been pronouncing it wrong.
Yeah. I call him Bro Die.
Oh, no.
Because when
it's
you get in the
Bro
ring
D.
with Bro, when you
it's
get in the
Bro
ring
D.
with Bro, you're dying.
Yeah, well, it's Bro D.
Yeah.
And I wasn't going to argue with him, so okay. Yeah.
Look, there's only a couple people his size that could probably.
Yeah, I'm not one of them.
Introducing yeah. first. He is from the other side of the train tracks and weighs in at 375 pounds per yard. He is Freight Train Brody Bodkins. His opponent weighs in at 264 kilograms, and he is the king of the Amazon, Hadari!
All right, we got two big behemoths getting ready to go at it here.
This is like watching one of those kaiju battles.
Yeah.
Do you know what that is, Pete?
Probably don't.
They're like big monsters, kind of like watching Godzilla versus King Kong.
Oh, okay. I got you now. I watched that kid.
I watched it as an adult.
I watched the original black and white versions of them.
Well, that's because that was the only kind of TVs around then.
Yeah. Yeah.
Weren't you surprised when the whole world went to color?
So here we go.
Oh, let me turn the crowd noise back on.
Yes.
And we got a whole face full of backside of Hadari right there. Yeah. That happens. You know, one time I was running camera, and I was like, I knew Jed, Hillbilly Jed was in the ring, and I knew he was about to set up for his cannonball, and I'm like, I'm going to get this shot. And I paid dearly for it. He came in there so hard. That not only did he go through his opponent, but he went through the turnbuckle, slammed into my camera. Camera then slammed into my nose, cracked my nose.
So that's what happened to your face.
No, I was just born like this.
Born that way? Okay.
Yeah.
Anyway, getting back to the match earlier, I'll tell you, when I saw Brody push Hadari back in the ring, I didn't really see anybody do that with Hadari.
Right, yeah, he was manhandling him, going for the big one. No, only a one count he was, but now Hadari picking up speed,
yep,
getting right. the advantage over Brody, which is a little surprising.
Right. Smart move right here, though. Rolled out of the ring, get your composure. You just got hit with a big, looked like big cross body. You know, get your composure. Get a little rest. You got till 10 to get back. Well, 9, get back in.
I'm muting this All right, now we're going for a test of strength here, which I think that could go either way. Well, that was a short test.
Right.
That
I was
like
going to give
quiz.
That advantage to Brody just because of his height.
Yes, that was a pop quiz of strength.
Yeah.
Oh, just he got airborne on that clothesline.
Wow. I mean, took the breath right out of him.
That happens to me when I get the KFC mashed potato bowl.
Yeah. Yeah. Got a stern glare for our ref just then. Crowd trying to get behind Hadari, trying to get him going. I'm just not sure if they're going to be able to.
Choking him against the ropes,
yeah,
I mean.
He's struggling to get his breath back, man. He's not giving him any chance to get a rest. As soon as he breaks the count, he gets right back on him.
I read him, song popped into my head.
Get a good look at him! Get a good look at him!
Still coughing. Tried to suck down the mac and cheese too fast.
You're supposed to chew that turkey before you swallow it, dude.
Yeah, well, it's good. And look, yeah. I'm weird. I like cold turkey more than I like hot turkey. Yeah. But Brody just still manhandling Hadari here, completely taking over this match.
Hadari, he's probably, that neck has been injured, and he's still struggling to get his breath. He can't hardly breathe. Every time Brody gets a break, like I said, he's going to break the count here, but he goes right back to it again.
And there's only so many warnings. And look, using the tape to choke, how is that not a disqualification?
I mean, that was just blatant. Look.
Yeah, how is that not a DQ?
Look, you've already warned him a few times, man. Enough is enough. He
said yes. And it's time for a change. Okay, there's a Jeff Jarrett. No, Owen Hart. Yeah.
Yeah.
The crowd getting behind Hadari here.
I don't think right now it's not making any difference.
No, it's not.
Wait a minute.
Brody don't care about the crowd. He don't care about your feelings. He don't care about who you're cheering for, who you like. Yeah. He cares about one thing, and that's himself.
He raked them eyes. Oh.
Off the rope anyway. Oh, and Hadari and Brody collide in the air in the middle of the ring. It was like watching two trains crash into each other.
That's some force coming right there. You can hear the crowd. Well, listen. Look, who's going to get up first?
Stop picking Bruce's nose.
Oh, Hadari got to his feet first.
Yeah, but Brody's up too.
Oh, big shoulder tackle right there. Trying to save him up for another one. Does he have enough in him, though? That's the thing. Oh, he got him up.
Well, the lights went out, and there's Jackson Morgan standing in the ring. Now, we saw Brody attack him last week while he was looking for Rachel, seemingly.
Here we go.
And Jackson just going at him now, getting his revenge. We know the match has been made for Black Friday next week between these two for the territorial championship.
Look. They're just going at it. The crowd needs to be careful. These guys come across that rail, it could be in big trouble. Watch out,
they're
Grandpa.
They're just battling. They're just, it's like a hockey fight.
Oh.
And they're coming through here. Fortunately, we can't get a camera through there.
Hope they don't come in here.
They won't. I got the door locked.
Well, they've got the pig face.
That is not nice.
Give it up for Hadari.
Oh, my goodness. I can't wait to tell Nikki what you said.
Oh, it's on Facebook Live. Show you.
Yeah.
You're the one that said it, though. You're the one that said it.
Well, Hadari with the victory.
That is true, yes. I'm going to step out for a second here. I'm going to get somebody to come in. Let's see who I can find to come in and do commentary with it.
Who's ready for your next matchup?
I'm ready for my next plate of mac and cheese.
There you go.
Introducing first.
Yeah. Let's see what we got coming to the ring. Oh, yeah. Well, folks, all I know is them two guys, they're still battling out back in the back. We can't get a camera to you, but them guys are still fighting. We're trying to get them pulled apart. It's chaos back here in the back.
And their opponents.
Time. We are getting ready to have a tag team match here shortly, but man. We'll give you any updates from the back if we can get this pulled, get these guys pulled apart. All right, we got the highlight reel. Coming to the ring, tag team champs. Be a good matchup here.
Is it Christian Cash?
Yeah.
Introducing first the challengers. They're a combined weight of 350 pounds. The team of the Lavender Lover, Kevin Panic. And Mo Money, Christian Cash.
You are being rude. My hand goes up, your mouth goes shut. Okay? You're going to give me respect. You are going to respect us. You see his hand? Y'all know what it means. You're going to listen to this woman say my name.
And his partner, Mo Money, Christian Cash. And your WCWO Tag Team Champions. They are the realest tag team there is. Damon Real, the highlight reel. And this match is for the tag team titles.
All right, Pete, Reggie Evers, Big Pete. Pete, I've been all over the place back here trying to figure out what's going on. It's been a crazy night, Pete, but look, here so we are.
You just got in here. I told the folks we're going to give them an update. Have they got those two behemoths broke up, Jackson Morgan and Brody? I mean, they were fighting through the back. Last I seen, they were still battling it out there back in the gravel.
Yeah, so they obviously everybody saw what happened in the ring just now. They did brawl to the back. Shortly after they got to the back, Brody just took off. He had enough. He was angry, pissed off. He stormed out, Pete.
That's good. That's
I guess, you know, if you can't take the heat, don't start the fire. He started a fire last week with Jackson Morgan, and I don't think he understood what he was getting himself into and what he had really started and initiated with that attack. Because Jackson Morgan's been angry all week long. We've seen Jackson Morgan angry. It's not a pretty sight. So hopefully the match has been signed for next Friday at Black Friday between Jackson Morgan and Brody Bogdanovich. It is official. Territorial championship match is going to happen. I'm going to be honest, Pete. I haven't seen a real threat to Jackson Morgan's territorial title since until that with Brody Bogdanovich. Tom Van Zandt stole the title from Jackson Morgan. I don't know if we can count him as a challenge because he didn't show up for a month and a half after he won the belt.
Yep.
But Brody Bogdanovich has been the most consistent, biggest real challenge.
And right, I mean, he doesn't seem like he fears him.
He doesn't. He doesn't, which is scary. Because how do you not fear a monster like Jackson Morgan, Pete? How do you not fear that? How are you not afraid? I just don't think it's registered with Brody yet. But you know what? It's going to register next Friday.
Yeah, look. One-on-one. And then you're going for his belt next week. These last couple of weeks, you know, you've attacked him from behind, then you guys battle. And here the next week, you're trying to take his belt from him.
Well, let's
give me a whole different story.
Well, let's look at what's happening in the ring right now. I mean, three-time tag team champions, the highlight reel. Tell me a little bit about these two guys that they're taking on right now. We've seen them once at the Outlaw Arena, but they're still barely newcomers. Fans not loving them.
No.
Tell me a little bit about what you know of these two men, Pete.
Well, I know they first time we saw them, they were in that four-way tag match.
Yep.
That was very interesting. I believe it was, had the I think the highlight reel was in that match. We had Ruthless Domination, and it was just pure chaos during that whole match, and the highlight reel got the victory on it. But these guys aren't no stranger to the ring. You know, they've been around, not long, but they're good. Just haven't been to the dub.
Absolutely. Welcome additions, because the tag team division, we've talked about it a million times. We've talked about it to death, but it still goes without saying. The tag team division in the fall of 2021 is nowhere near. It's evolved immensely since the fall of 2020, Pete. We
yes.
have a tag team division.
Yes,
a year
we
ago
do.
This time, it was the highlight
yeah,
reel.
Tag teams are wanting to come down here. And
yes.
look, right now, the highlight reel, not only are they like tag team champs here at WCWO, but they're like one of the top tag teams in Indiana in the Midwest.
They were just named. They were just yep. named tag team of the year from the Hoosier Wrestling Alliance.
People. Yes,
and rightly so. I can't. They have gold everywhere. Three different promotions right now. Gold in three different promotions, Pete. DCCW, BMFX, WCWO. I can't think of a tag team in Indiana that could stand a chance against the highlight reel. They're champions in three promotions for a reason, Pete. And look, a year ago, the tag team division here was mainly the highlight reel, the Russian Assassins, and Ruthless Domination. So not to take anything away from Ruthless Domination, but they were also, half of their team was injured for the majority of last year,
yeah.
going into early 2021. So when the highlight reel had the tag team championships last year, who was going to step up to the plate?
You think about, I mean, look who they beat to win the titles the first time. The Knockout Society.
The Knockout Society had to reform just so the highlight reel would have opponents.
Yeah. So then later on, though, I mean, these titles have changed hands since they won the initial titles. They were stripped of the titles, won them back.
Yep.
Then they lost the titles to Revelation, I believe
yep.
it was.
Yep.
Then Revelation lost them to Utter Chaos.
Yep.
And then Utter Chaos ended up losing to Ruthless Domination.
Yep.
And then the highlight reel ended up taking them back from Ruthless Domination. So it's not like we haven't had tag teams in here. We've had
yes.
good tag teams in here.
Yeah, absolutely. And that says a lot for how far our tag team division has come in the last 9 to 10 months, where we have, like you said, multiple tag team champions to stand a chance at holding that gold. And then new coming tag teams wanting to come in and work with our tag. I mean, it's really cool to see how far along this division has come over the last year. And, you know, the highlight reel appreciates it too, because they have legitimate challenges. They don't want a night off. They don't want to wrestle against teams that are just two wrestlers thrown together to have a tag team match. They want to wrestle against tag teams because that's how you get better. The highlight reel has obviously gotten better since their initial tag team run at the beginning of the year.
And they've had some great matchups all over the state.
They're being talked about everywhere, Pete. And so when a team like Cash and Payne comes in, the highlight reel, they see dollar signs.
And I'm going to tell you right, these two guys, they're not only are they a great tag team, they're great single wrestlers also. Because these two guys put on one heck of a show when they had to fight each other in the Young Gun tournament.
I would like to see that again because I didn't get to see that at the Young Guns tournament. I would love to see that again.
That could easily be match of the year. Them guys, they gave it all.
Well, and you knew that was going to be a good match because of how familiar they are with each other. Pete, they're twins. They literally think alike.
Yeah. Is he going to be able to get over there, make the tag? So far, no.
Oh, and it ends Geary from Damon. Damien reaching his hand and the tag. Oh, it's on, Pete. It is on. Damien with a standing drop kick. Clothesline. Another clothesline. Oh, it's rolling. The highlight reel is rolling. Yep. And they've got
Damon
this other. They've got
Damon
their opponents reeling.
Damon is on fire right now.
Oh, look at that tilt-a-whirl slam. Pete.
Damon's on fire, man. Look. No, you don't.
Oh, and an Ooh, and the exploder suplex.
Yeah.
Who wants to see it?
Yeah. Oh, corner clothesline. Oh. Running in corner. Oh, and a knee to the gut.
Wow.
What a maneuver.
Yes. Going for the three. Oh, just a two count.
And Payne able to kick out just in time, Pete. That match should have been won. But yep. this new tag team, not willing to die, not willing to quit just yet.
Oh, still got a lot of fight in him. Oh, big elbow to the face.
Payne elbows out. He's punching Damon while he's down. He's trying to get the advantage because look, if you take any sort of breather against a highlight reel, they are going to beat you.
Look, he just came with a vicious chop me. Here's a big blow to your chest, man. Set him up.
Ooh. Oh. Hard elbow to the face. That got him good. Oh, and another one. He got him good.
He's firing all cylinders right now.
That's one.
Man. Two for two. Is he going to do three amigos?
He shook him so hard, even the camera shook.
Zero.
Oh.
Christian Cash is going up top.
Setting him up. Nice elbow. Can he finish it?
Damien in with the save. It's not over yet. These two guys proving why they are the three-time tag team champions. But right. Cash and Payne trying to prove why they deserve to be the tag team champions. Somebody has to knock off the champions at some point. These two men want their first tag team title reign.
All the way to the floor.
That could be the opening the highlight reel needs. That could be it.
What?
Super kick to the face. That's it, Pete. That's got to be it. He takes him in. He's got to pick him up. They're going for their finishing maneuver here.
Yep.
Oh, that is all she wrote, Pete. That should be it. Oh, not quite
yet. No.
What a save. What a save.
Pushed him right into him. All right, that match was over.
Beautiful Olympic slam from the highlight reel, Pete.
Yep.
Come on, Tammy.
Here we go. They're trying it one more time.
That is all she wrote.
That should be
it. Yep. Kicks him to the side, kicks him to the ground. That's it.
Two and three.
The highlight reel continues.
Your winners and still your tag team champions. The highlight reel.
They've knocked off every tag team that has come through these doors. They continue to stand strong as our tag team champions.
Yep, look, they were pushed to their limits tonight, though, man. Are we seeing maybe shades of a possible tag team that can maybe take the titles from the highlight reel?
If any team can take the
give
belts,
it up
then
again,
it's Captain
the highlight
Tag.
Reel.
They almost took the belts from them tonight. Didn't quite have enough, but they walked out, even without a victory, they walk out with enough tape to watch, to scout the highlight reel and figure out what they did wrong, what they didn't do enough of to win those belts. So it's going to be interesting to see if we see this matchup again. I would love to see it.
Oh, yeah, that was a good matchup. These are the matches you can see each and every week right here, every Friday night.
November's been a good month, Pete.
Give it up again for your tag team champions, the Highlight Reel.
Good job. Keep it picking to come next week, man. They got that big match next week.
They have the gauntlet match next week.
Yeah, they are.
Anybody can walk out with the belts next week in the gauntlet match. That's what gauntlets do. We'll see if they can withstand.
We know who's team number one, but we don't know who the other teams are.
I want to be surprised just like everyone else. I don't even want to see them draw names. I don't want to see them draw numbers. I want to be surprised. Well, guys, we're going to take a short intermission. We'll be back soon. Stay tuned because the second half of the show is going to be hotter
than this. And right now, we're going to take an intermission. quick. Who's ready to get back into our next matchup? Introducing first.
All right, we're back with the second half of the show. Grab your popcorn, grab your drinks, get ready. We got Juwan Thomas coming to the ring. He's ready. Big matchup coming up tonight with him.
And his opponent.
Got the frat boy himself, JB, coming to the ring. We've already seen one of the guys that's going to be in the triple threat match for the Gunslinger title victorious tonight. We'll see a second. He's going to have his fans full with Juwan Thomas.
Yeah. All right. I think I got us stuck in this room, Pete. That's right. You don't like the red ones, do you?
Oh, I like the red.
Oh, I'm all right, man.
Yeah.
Introducing first, from Indianapolis, Indiana, he is the Naptown Nightmare, Juwan Thomas. And his opponent is here to tap the kegs and paddle those pledges. He is JB.
All right. Whoa, right off the bat.
Look, never turn your back. The opponent, especially when it's Juwan Thomas.
You know, and we've seen this from Juwan for consecutive weeks now, where he just, as soon as that bell rings, he's like a bull when you yell ole. Like, you're getting it.
He's not here to impress the fans. He's here to win.
And that's what happens when you tell a bad joke about Russians and being the KGB. There's the Office reference for the week.
Of which I wouldn't know, because I do not watch The Office.
And B finally firing back. Get some wind under his sails. Deep arm drag by the frat boy.
I just hope Juwan Thomas has good dental insurance after what we saw.
And the Party Monster with a hell of a drop kick, taking Juwan off his feet again.
I don't think he finds parties. I think parties find him.
That's typically how it happens in college. I think I had more nights sleeping in bushes than I did in my dorm.
I think Jay Beef just standing there and the party just starts around him.
Well, it's always a party with Jay Beef. Except now. Well, even then, in his mind after taking that, it's a party. Kick out after two, but I'm pretty sure he's seeing unicorns and Tweety Bird.
Yep. Yeah, I don't think nobody's going to get her and make you, Juwan.
Yeah, I certainly ain't. Oh!
Come on, Jay.
Just teed off on the ribs there. Looking like Rodrigo Blankenship of the Colts. Went a little left.
I'm just thinking about the drumstick finale on Thursday night.
The drumstick finale on Thursday night.
Yeah, we're going to put two drumsticks and let them all battle out for it. Thanksgiving night, man. They're going to battle for the two drumsticks.
I might be there for that.
Yeah.
I might be there for that. me and you both get in there, it'll be like a game of Hungry Hungry Hippos.
Heck yeah. So boy. Like we said earlier, folks, I know we got a big match going right now, but we got two big shows next week.
Oh, and a hell of a black hole slam by Juwan. Going for the pin. One, two, and somehow Beef kicked out of that.
Yeah.
That was such a big black hole slam. Somewhere Sublime is singing about it.
Man, that was I don't even know how JB was even kicked out of that.
Was that Sublime that saying that? I gotta reference that. I gotta see if that reference was on cue or not. Part of me thinks it wasn't.
Wouldn't be the first time.
Yeah, there was that one time when I was asked if I was a god, and I said no, and then a friend of mine reminded me, Ray, when someone asks if you're a god, you always say yes. No, that was Soundgarden. Damn.
No loss.
Soundgarden's good.
Yeah, but I'm saying it's no
Whoa, loss. Hold on there. B picked up Juwan, but Juwan was having none of it. Got out. Kicked to the breadbasket. He got him up again. He's been working on the squats.
He got him.
TKO, is that it for Juwan?
Is he going to get the victory here? Juwan
looks
out.
One, two, three. Oh!
Wow, just kicked out.
He just came to right in the nick of time. Uh-oh, shirt's off. Sun's out, guns out. Let's do it, JB.
The party's on.
Up, caught him. Belly to back suplex sends JB flying like he was running from excise. Oh, and a knee right to the shoulder, chest. Oh, and a brain buster to boot.
That could be it.
One, two, no.
Man. Juwan's like, what more? What else do I got to do?
I think you got to expel him.
Oh.
JB over here feeling like Rodney Dangerfield, thinking he gets no respect. Got the paddle. Missed. A little tardy swinging that. Hey, I got the puns ready,
no.
Man. Oh, is he going to spank
him? Is he going to try to paddle him?
Get in position. Well, the referee, Angel, took the paddle away, letting him know that that would have been a DQ.
Oh.
But what she didn't see was cheating on the test by Juwan Howard. One, two, three. That is it. He escaped.
Yeah.
Hell of a match.
Juwan took it to the kids.
Well, Juwan understood the assignment. Juwan came out victorious.
I see someone watches TikTok.
Well, it looks like it'll be back to school for JB. Starting making sure it'll feel like Groundhog Day at this point to him.
Juwan's like the substitute teacher to his kids, man. Taught them a lesson tonight. I guess not only does wrestling got a picture of turning their back to Juwan, refs need to not turn their back also.
Oh, yeah, he definitely showed that.
Once again, your winner, Juwan Thomas.
Angel Jacobs calling Juwan a cheater. It's only cheating if you get caught. How do you think I graduated college? I found this website called SpeedRight when I was in college. It's amazing. You literally just copy text, paste it in there, and it says the same thing, just rewrites it for you. It's amazing. Also, one time I wrote a 4-page paper on how to make a grilled cheese sandwich. Also turned in a physics paper on how the Wile E. Coyote could actually catch the Roadrunner.
He's double wide. She went double space.
No, I legit did it like a half hour before the class started, too. It
Your
took me more time to find a
Brooklyn.
Printer in the college.
Introducing first.
That's why I'm sitting here with no health insurance now. Great life choices. All right, well, it looks like Blake hired a spotlight operator after firing everyone last week.
Well, that's some music I have not heard in a long time.
Does the Macho Man come back from the dead? Oh, that's the Russians.
That's the Russians.
Well, they were here last week.
I wasn't.
Yeah, you didn't miss anything with these guys. You know, I could have gone longer without hearing their music.
Yep.
Where's Rocky when you need him?
And their opponents.
I believe we got a triple tag team match coming up here.
Another one. Hey, but we try to get as many wrestlers in on a card as we can here. Is this the Titanic theme song? Somebody's heart's gonna go on. All right. Whoa. Camera, is she there?
Down in front.
This music I recognize.
Yeah.
Every Gen X mom is up and dancing on a car now.
Trying to keep that straight tunnel vision.
Yes. Then you get blinded by the spotlight. That was a song, too. Who sang that? That wasn't Hall & Oates, was it?
Was it?
Blinded by the light. That wasn't Hall & Oates, was
no,
it?
No.
We
don't need your permission
to speak. Introducing first. Representing the USSR, Russian Assassin number 8 and Russian Assassin 75.
75 of them bastards have made it into
There's
the country.
Team number 2, from the Dominican Republic, he is Cecil Cerveza.
Oh, man for man, that's right, yeah.
And he is VC's most wanted, Mikhail Murphy. Team number 3. Are from Indianapolis, Indiana, the team of Scorpion and Hammer, Ruthless Domination.
All right, so some triple threat tag team action happening. Who are you pointing at there, Pete? Yeah, I'm not worried about rats.
Yeah.
I'm also not worried about getting in trouble for what I say. Blake don't care.
Yeah. Hey,
it feels good to be on the side of the boss for once,
I'll
be honest.
Sometimes my mind draws a blank, but what is it?
Sometimes.
With one member of each team, we're in the ring at the same time. What kind of rules is that again?
Tornado tag.
Yeah, I'd love to see that. Right now.
It's too cold for tornadoes, though. There's not enough warm air in the atmosphere.
So we could have a tornado later in the week when it warms back up again.
You probably will. You know, our weather in Indiana is controlled by Sybil. That's a reference you can get. Good old Sally Field movie there. Before she was Forrest Gump's mom. Oh, and the Russians just sandwich. What's his name? Mikkel. Right? Did I get that right? Mikkel?
What's that?
I don't know. And Russian number 8,722 with the body slam.
Yeah, here's, look, at least when they had their manager out there, he was able to talk to them and control them. Now, I mean.
Well, luckily we got at least one of them deported.
Can the referee.
Some Cold War evidence came out and he was gone.
Is he part of the Russian collusion?
And, well, he went for a sleeper hold out of nowhere. I don't know if he can spell or say collusion.
Right in the side of the head.
That was nice of him to move his hand first.
Yep.
I'm gonna talk crap and then call for the ref. You're like that kid in a Christmas story who finally got beat up by Ralphie.
Oh, snap them fingers.
Now, man, it's cold enough in here. See if you can get his tongue stuck to one of the ring posts.
Yes, sir.
And Scorpion in the ring. Laying waste to Cecil Cerveza. I might have had one too many of those.
Yes.
Actually, it was peanut butter whiskey, and it was delicious. You know, with the family coming for Thanksgiving, got to get ahead on all the drinking so I can tolerate them.
You'd be drunk for a while, won't you?
Yep. Till January 2nd. Going for the pin, 1-2. Kick out, quick kick out at 2, though.
Yep. All right, here we go.
And, oh, power slam by Hammer. 1-2. Kick out at 2.
Blocked by the ref there. Taking that knee away from it, knee ain't gonna be worth a darn come tomorrow. Come on.
And the double hip toss by Hammer and Scorpion. Ruthless domination, going for the pin, 1-2. Another kick out by Cecil Cerveza. He just won't give up.
Oh, couldn't see why that looked like. Might have been a little bit of eye gouge there.
Hey, tell them to take it home, Brooke. Brooke, tell them to take it home. It's gone on too long. All right.
Here we go.
Oh!
Assassins!
Well, that's something different. That's something we haven't seen. The Russians victorious?
Yeah, they basically look.
What happened with Hammer and Scorpion? They got having
through,
an awful
one got threw out the ring and one got pushed off.
Hey, man, even the Bulls in their heyday had a few off nights. They had 10 of them in one season.
Even a broken clock is right twice a day, man.
That is true.
Any given Friday, baby, that's what we say here. Any given Friday.
Who says that? I've never heard anybody say that. Never heard anyone say that. Trying to refresh it. Hey guys, if you comment, we'll answer it. If you got questions, we'll answer it. Also, we can tell you with just like 15 minutes, how to save 15% of your car insurance. Or also, we can give you some great restaurants to go to, especially in the Mooresville area.
Yeah.
You know what? I'm going to.
If you're looking for pizza.
You want to give it up for the Russians?
No. Yeah.
Got to give a shout out to Rowdy's, man.
Right. Hold on. Let me get it up here.
Please welcome to the ring, Reggie Edwards.
Well, let's go to the
How's
ring.
How's everybody doing?
We got.
Ladies and gentlemen, if you were here last week watching on Facebook, you saw the altercation between Joey Owens and Blake Money Wright. Let's go and welcome him back to the Outlaw Arena. Joey Owens! Everybody wants to know, first off, where are you at mentally after last week, everything that's happened? We haven't heard from you. How are you doing?
You know, when I lost a match, when I lost a company, I didn't know what to do. I literally thought it was over. I mean, you know, we've talked. You know where I was at. I was out fishing most of the time, and everybody knows I love fishing. And I'm sitting there thinking, how in the hell did I just lose my dad's company? My dad has been running WCWO over 25 years. Then you know, my son Jonathan, you know, he retired. He don't wrestle no more. He's like, Dad, how are you going to let Papa's company go just like that? He goes, we haven't heard from you. Nobody's seen from you. He says, it's time. He goes, you know, everybody knows I've been in a dark place lately. A lot of things happened in my life. A lot of times I didn't know if I was coming or going. And I did realize as I was gone, watching what was going on here at WCWO, getting the phone calls from all the guys in the back talking how big of a piece of crap Blake Money Wright is.
Blake sucks! 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 Blake
so,
Blake sucks!
Then, last week, you seen what happened last week. Then he's going to call my mom after the show and try to give my mom shit. And he's went too far right there. So I tell you what, December the 3rd, I will be the new owner of WCWO again. And I guarantee you, because everybody in the back, even you know, and these fans know, he is the biggest piece of shit that ever stepped in this building. What's wrong, Blake? Your mic don't work? Look, nobody in this building wants to hear what you got to say. What? Are you coming out here? You want to fight right now? Huh? Come on, Blake. Put the company up right now. I'm ready. Come on. Look. What?
Give me the microphone.
Come on.
Someone bring me a damn microphone.
What did you do? Go sell that other microphone that actually worked?
Give me a microphone!
Oh, wait a minute, wait a minute. Did you go sell it to pay for your new truck because your car lost its hood? That was good, right? Oh, that was mean? No, what's mean is you tormenting everybody in this damn building. That's what's mean!
Hold on, first off, guess what? I have the damn microphone! First things first, let's talk about pieces of shit. Like this doofus in the red shirt. Where's your damn tie? I've warned you time in and time out. So Reggie Edwards, you're fired! So now Joey, you invited this piece of garbage into my building. And look at you, you're delusional. The last time that you and I stepped in the ring, I dropped you right on your thick skull and sent you right to Eskenazi. And you have the gall to stand here in front of me and have this little family therapy session? Well, guess what? I don't give a damn about your legacy. So I'm going to ask you one and one time only, Joey. Leave my building.
You know what, Blake? I'm not leaving this damn building. This is my building. This is my family's legacy. It's not yours, and you cannot make me leave. Won't you be a man, and let's get it on right now.
Do you know who I am? You're not going to leave my building? Do you not know the levels that I will go? So I asked you one time to leave my building, and I warned you. So, I want you to leave my building or I will burn this piece of shit building and your family's legacy to the ground. So what's it gonna be? Am I gonna burn down 1151 South Kentucky Avenue? Your dad's house? Your son's house? Your house? Or are you gonna leave? What's it gonna be?
On it right there on the ground.
Reggie
I guarantee you'll fight me. Come on, December 3rd, me and you, go back out.
Yeah.
Come on. If you guarantee it, I'll leave.
Joey, he's gonna cry.
You got it. Now leave. 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 I won't burn it to the ground. Leave. Right through the front door. Right where your buddy Max Sterling went. Leave.
Matt, what did we see here? I cannot believe what we just saw.
I mean, I can.
I mean, look, I understand.
Look, Blake don't care about WCWO. He just cares about costing Joey everything. I know this. He's literally told me that.
I just couldn't believe he would take it that far to actually.
Oh, well, hold on. I think Jed's going to talk now. We don't hear that often.
Now that the trash is gone, let's get on with the main event.
All right. Well, yeah.
Here for your lovely
Blake
announcer, Nikki.
Literally threatening to burn the place to the ground. Lots of language in that promo. So I got the mic that wasn't working for him. Let's see if it's working.
Test. Hey, you know what? You can hear it on the broadcast.
Let's give it up for Hillbilly Jed.
Yeah, like, look, I can use this one. Can you hear me?
Well, because it's probably still coming over there.
You should probably be able to hear it out of your left ear.
No.
I know.
Anyway, well, I mean, look, folks. All I can say, Reggie's fired.
Yeah, is that a loss?
Thank goodness, though. I mean, no matter how you feel about the match, I don't want to see nobody get burned up, man. That was crazy. Now, Phil out there trying to clean the ring up.
There's a few people I wouldn't mind seeing a little extra crispy in a bucket of chicken.
But.
Dave. Phil's trying to clean up the ring. You can smell the gasoline.
No, I didn't.
Yeah, so, like, man, Pete, can you smell the gasoline back here?
Yes.
I mean, I promise, that wasn't me this time.
No, that is actual gasoline. Yeah. I mean, it is working its way back here. I know the fans are smelling. Look.
Yeah, it, again, like, you know, Phil's trying to clean it up. I don't know why they shut off the lights.
Yeah, he just had to clean up the spill that Blake caused in here.
Spill, that's a nice way of putting it.
Yeah. Oh, no, that's gas, not water. Come smell it. It's gas. Who's ready for your next matchup? Introducing first.
So, yeah, we're getting ready for the main event. You saw it advertised on our Facebook page. Obviously, you guys have found that. That's why you're here, unfortunately, listening to us.
Yeah.
Oh, that terrible music making dogs bark and go crazy. The most annoying entrance music. I think I would rather listen to Reggie sing Hit Me Baby One More Time. Oh, I can't. Because he's been fired. You know, I'm told him, I brought him ties to wear. He didn't want to listen. Didn't listen.
Yeah, and then he got mad at me because I wouldn't call him Mr.
And
Wright.
His opponent.
I'm the only one that, like, doesn't have a problem with doing what I'm told here. Why is that?
Yeah, it's like
a job. We get paid to do the job.
He got upset with me, said, you won't call him Mr. Wright. I'm like, he didn't tell me to call him Mr. Wright.
Right, yeah, he didn't tell you that, right. But yeah, as advertised on our Facebook page, the main event, Dutch Boy Platinum, teaming up with Jordan James, accompanied by Skull Crusher, going up against an unlikely duo here, in Dex Royal and Rachel Armstrong. And I was curious, I asked Dex, like, what is, you know, you're teaming with Rachel, I don't get it. And, you know, he was like, look, I'm just proving that I can beat,
and
I can
their
beat
opponents.
With anybody as my teammate. Anybody. And I'm proving that. And he said, Rachel, he's like, look, Rachel can hold her own against these guys anyway.
Well, you know, not here in the building, but Rachel has beaten Jordan James.
Yeah. I mean, look, Rachel has beat
both her opponents tonight.
And he said he has the confidence in her. So,
and her tag team partner.
Comes her tag partner, Dex Royal. It's a big matchup right here. 1 week away from Blake Friday.
Introducing first, team number one, Dutch Boy Platinum. And accompanied to the ring by Skull Crusher, he is Jordan James. Their opponents.
It's Joe Kim,
she is Starfire Rachel Armstrong. And your WCWO Outlaw Champion, Air Canada, Dex Royal.
All right, I'm back. Had to go swap out camera batteries there so that we can keep the camera on.
Yeah.
Yeah, I wouldn't try to. Yeah, maybe that corner worked for it. Yeah, there we go. That'll charge that one.
There you go.
It won't really get much charge.
Yeah, but.
Oh no, that thing takes forever to charge.
Okay.
like 10 hours actually. Yeah. All right, so yeah, like I said, unlikely duo here in Dex and Rachel teaming up against the newly styled Dutch Boy Platinum and Jordan James.
What's
our friendship?
Oh, I guess he just pissed the friendship away, evidently, is what he's saying.
You know, I don't think it was much of a friendship. It was pretty one-sided. You know, friendships, relationships don't need to be transactional.
Look, Dex tagged in to go up against Jordan. Jordan made a quick tag.
Of course he did.
Dutch boy in.
He's skirt. That's why. He's skirt. Or he's whatever the fans are chanting right now. All right, and they've locked up here, Dutch Boy and Dex. Up, going for the back suplex there. Dex got out of it. Leapfrog, rolled over. Went for the leg. Oh, caught him.
Big boot to the face there.
I think they call that the pistol kick. It's like a pistol shoots a bullet. The hammer hits it, then shoots it out.
Yeah. Man, it always amazes me when Dex gets up high with them drop kicks, man.
That's a
tag. Oh, and there's Rachel. Well, I thought she was going for a pin, but no. Oh, now she is. That might have cost one, two. Yeah.
Yeah,
she might have had that if she went right off the back.
Yeah, exactly. About 2.5 count there.
Trying to whip him in. Oh, and Dex caught him with a right. Now Rachel was able to get him. And a splash. I don't know how effective the splash was. Big size difference there.
Yeah.
That's like me getting hit in the face by a grasshopper. I'm pretty much going to win that. Oh, and a springboard leapfrog going for the pin.
Oh, Dex
rolled over. And Dex,
Jordan James may have crossed himself.
But look, there was the pin and the referee distracted. Smart move by Jordan there. I'll call him dirty. I won't call him dumb.
Yeah.
I'll call him a lot of things, but I can't say he's dumb. And the schoolboy pin was not effective there. And Dex caught Dutch Boy with a hell of a knee to the face.
Hold them eyes to the back of his head.
There's the go to sleep. Then there's the just go to hell. That's what that was. And Rachel, whoa. What a unique pinning maneuver. What was that, a hip toss over Dutch Boy into the sunset flip there?
And there's some.
Yeah. Up, Dutch Boy with the reversal. And Rachel goes flying over the rope.
There we go.
Oh, and of course. Yeah, that's your son. You proud of that? Are you proud of that?
Look, man, what you just said earlier, Matt, it ain't cheating if you don't get caught.
I didn't say it was cheating. I didn't say he's cheating. That's just dirty. You know, you would think he would try that on Dex, but I guess he's too scared. Just dropped her on her face. Just very disrespectful.
Two guys look like they're trying to take all the revenge out on her for their losses they had to her. Wait a minute. Come on, ref. Give him up the hair, ref.
Right. Like, he's not even counting.
Yeah, I mean, dang.
I would ask if your son, like, slipped him a 20 or something, but I don't think he can afford to do that. Oh, yeah.
Oh.
And just thrusting the shoulders into her abdomen. I know, the ref not, Dex, you're right. The ref not even counting, telling him to get out of the corner. Oh, but now you want to react to that? This is clearly one-sided. Is that Nick Patrick in the ring? Come on.
Right now, Rachel's trying to fight back, best to know that.
I don't even think she's trying. And the ref's not even worried about it. She's out of it.
Yeah, I mean, she just.
What? Oh, unique move there. Sunset flip into a German suplex.
Wow.
One, two, kick out by Rachel Armstrong.
Man.
I didn't know if she was still alive, honestly.
Yeah, because, I mean, she looked like a rag doll over there.
Yeah.
Just throwing her around. Look. Oh, man, going against that joint on that elbow.
And look, Dutch boy. Taunting Dex, like, yeah, here's the hand. She's trying to tag you. Watch me break it.
Man. She is taking a heck of a beating tonight. Mae's putting all kinds of pressure on that arm.
One, two. No, referee a little out of position. If he was in the right position, that could have been a three count.
Yep, Jordan James about to come back in the ring again.
Yay.
Uh-oh.
Oh, and Rachel with the ole causing Jordan to get speared through the middle rope by his own tag team partner. But can she make the tag? Does she have enough to get across the ring to tag Index Royal? And oh, smart move by Dutch Boy. Not even giving her the opportunity.
Post.
Yeah.
He could be out.
Not even giving her the opportunity. He recovered quickly and knew exactly what to do. What tune was he playing?
Rachel's in deep trouble now.
Oh, hell of a forearm to the back. You just heard the pop. Dex is recovered.
I don't know how much that took out of him because his head rang that pole.
Yeah, you can, it sounded like one of the Santa Clauses outside of a Walmart.
Dong.
And Dutch Boy with a suplex. Oh, I thought he was going to
onto a chokehold.
Just blatant. I mean, at least the ref counted that time.
We've said it before, but she is in the worst. She's got to get a tag,
I don't know how much life she has left in her. And Jordan James going up high. Is he going for a moonsault? Well, he's trying to get set, but Rachel's getting up. Oh, smart move by Rachel.
Oh,
and fired just a forearm to the jaw.
Get Jordan James in the head there.
Yeah. And she's trying. Oh, and she got into a DDT. But how much did that take out of her? She desperately needs to get this tag.
She's trying to get to Dex.
Dex is more anxious than a Karen waiting for her Black Friday TV deal to go to start.
Is she going to be able to get to the corner? Dex Boy's holding on.
Oh, just smacked him in the chest. Sure that burned.
Tag's been made.
Yeah, Dex got in. Oh, clothesline. Dutch boy catches the next one. Jordan yep. James, they both come back for more. Dex ducks under, grabs him. Oh! I don't even know what to call that.
Now, it's a nice move, man. I love
it. Just dumps Jordan. Oh, cut. You know what? I don't even know what to call this. Dex yeah. just on a whole nother level of creativity in this ring right now. I mean, normally we see those moves with two people doing them at once. But Dex doing this all on his own. He's getting ready.
Yep. Looks like he's tagging Rachel in.
I thought we were about to see Air Canada here. Up, oh, faked it, and there it is. Whoa, took everyone out.
Look at somebody
took out Skull Crusher, took out Jordan James. I think Dutch Boy jumped out of the way at the last second. Yeah, he did.
Yep.
And he just slams Dex into the barricades over there. But Rachel, the legal one in. Oh, Jordan taking advantage here.
His Dex could be out over there.
Yeah.
He's barely moving.
He's been incapacitated here. What are they setting up for now? Oh, backbreaker across the knees. Dex sliding in. One, two, and he got the breakup right at the
yeah.
last second.
What was... Jordan, he didn't see Dex coming in the ring.
And folks,
oh, no.
I do want to announce, like, our main event brought to you by Rowdies, Tattooligans, Curl Up and Die, all down in
Mooresville.
Yeah, Mooresville. We've done Inside the Dub Live.
Yep.
You know, so. But yeah, all those. I mean, they're all different locations, but they can all be found on Facebook. You know, just look up Tattooligans, Curl Up and Die, which is a hair salon down in Mooresville. I think that's where you get your hair done at.
Yeah.
Oh, and Jordan moved. Dutch Boy did not. Oh! That is it!
He just called for the bell. Ref did. So it must be a disqualification. Dex is looking crazy.
Dex has got those eyes. He's ready to kill
yeah,
some
he
your
does.
Winners, by way of disqualification, Rachel Armstrong and Dex Royal.
Ducked under. Oh, he caught him anyway. And Dex just snapped.
Yeah. But look, I don't think they cared about the victory. Damage has been done to Rachel. Somebody's got to get her and find out. Check on her.
I mean, I'm at a loss for words. That's your
yeah,
son.
Yeah, I'm like.
Who just hit her with a chair for no reason.
I'm
other than he couldn't
right
get
now.
The job done.
I'm speechless right
Once
now.
Once again, your winners. Dex Royal and Rachel Armstrong.
And he's still going after him.
We knew this was going to happen. Well, we're going to see those two go at it. One-on-one come next week, guys.
Well, he's got Skullcrusher tracked. But he knows, yep. His beef ain't with Skull Crusher.
Folks, don't forget, next week we're going to be here Thanksgiving night, same time, $5 admission. Then we're going to be here for Blake Friday night. Get all your shopping
Give
done
it up
early.
Again
Come see
for
us.
Sex Royal and Rachel Armstrong.
$5 admission Friday night.
Also be here Thanksgiving night for $5. It's only
yep.
$5.
$5.
Night.
Look, the stores are going to be closed. Get in here.
Yeah.
Have a good time.
Eat all the turkey. Take a nap because of the tryptophan. Then come in here. And just give it up again for Rachel and Zach. Who knows what you're going to see, honestly, that night.
Right now, we don't know what we're going to see.
Nothing has been released.
Everybody have a safe weekend.
Have a safe trip home. No. We will see you right back here next Friday night.
We will not know how the matches will be set until we get here. So.
Yeah.
Like we said, final admission on Thursday night, back to $12 on Friday night.
Yep.
Bell times, everything's going to be the same. $12. So,
yeah.
Bell time is 7:30 both nights. Doors 6:30.
All right. And once again, thank you for joining us this week. We will not be live next Thursday, but we will be live as long as we're sold out next Friday. For Blake Friday, we'll go live again.
Yep. And tune in to Inside the Dub.
Get here. You're going to want to see this. Yep.
And Inside the Dub be up next week. We'll figure out what's going on. I mean, Reggie's been fired. We'll just have to see what's going on, folks.